Hello everybody, this is Hazard here, and today I am going to bring you my very first video. My name is Alex, of course. Some of you may know me already from an older channel called This is Hazard, of course, but I deleted it because I felt like it. But newer viewers, of course, I told you my name is Alex, and I like to play games and yada yada. I already have a lot of games planned to play. I've got Kerbal Space Program, Minecraft, Slender, a couple other games, some random Flash games like Happy Wheels. There's random games that I've found, and also other people play, which I thought would be cool to review as well. Yeah. This is the same kind of wacky as well, and kind of a little bit random, I'm just going to say that. yeah, without further ado, let's start. Kerbal Space Program. It's a rather fun game. In fact, I played a bit of it before I started recording, and it's actually really fun. Let's just say that... yeah, I already have one. Okay. Yeah, let's just say that it's a little bit tricky, but once you know what to do, it's kind of easy. You have the plane hangar, the rocket hangar, the launching pad, and also the tracking station. People will think that making planes are easier than making rockets, but... no, they're not. No, it's just not. No. So it's going to make a simple rocket, and we might make a satellite. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a satellite. First, we need some kind of pod or a satellite to start off. So you can start off with cockpits, many command pods, some normal hardware, satellites. But we're going to start with simple Sputnik. Right. What we're going to do? First, we need... Basically, have different controls here of different parts, so we need something to. You just put one like that. It's kind of. It's really fun. It's really fun. You can make anything. Gonna try and make a basic satellite shape. So. Oh, that looks interesting. Oh. Ah, that looks interesting. All right. You can press the button here to put in symmetry mode and also to snap angle snap. Makes things a lot more easier. Ah, there we go. Ah, shit. Kind of fucked it. There's some basic things you do need on a satellite, though, first. Like, for example, solar panels, you know, what, basically what any satellite has. This is kind of screwing up. God damn it. Come on. Oh, fine. Screw you. Right. Let's try this. Okay, that looks good. We got to start. We got to start. We need some solar panels, if I remember correctly. No, that's a ladder, I think. Ah, these are solar panels. Sweet. I think... Oh, fuck. Kind of failed. Yeah, looks about right. Okay, so another pair of solar panels underneath. Okay, and once we get into orbit, those will deploy and all that. We need batteries. Something we need batteries all over this fucker. So we'll put it there. Okay. Put two. We also, to add a little bit more power, we'll also put these bolt radic. These are sorta like solar panels, but not really good ones. So we'll put those on here. Like that. Okay. Another thing to add a bit to it is communication. So we'll add a couple of these. These Commodatron 16, so simple, easy communication dealy thingies. I'm a man of science, so I don't really know, but yeah, I'll put it on anyway. Those extend and you also get basic communication, and also we'll add a more better one on top as well. So we'll put one in the middle. Something like that. Okay, now this is a little bit weird. Okay, I think we sorted it. Yeah, we sorted it. Okay. That, I think, is pretty much our basic satellite, but what we're going to do just for extra strength is we're going to put some struts on it so it doesn't wobble about like mad. Because we don't want that. Hang on, I'll put the symmetry mode on it. Okay. We'll put that there, and this one here. Sweet! Okay. I think we're pretty much ready. Yep, right, the satellite's ready. We need a rocket, of course, to get it into space. Right, what we'll do is, we'll need a decoupler. Well, did I put an SAS module? The SAS module is basically sort of like autopilot, where you snap it into an angle you want and it fixes it there so it doesn't wobble all over the place. So it helps. It really does help in rockets as well. Especially with a weird top like this, it won't be quite right, but you'll get what I mean. Right, we need a decoupler. No, that's not it. That's not one. Oh, that is one, but not the right one. This one will do. Here we go. Right. We've got a decoupler. Now we need some basic fuel, so a small, normal fuel tank. We'll probably get two of those. Oh, I just remembered something. I just remembered RCS. Obviously, within space, there isn't any air or gravity, so that if I start spinning, I won't be able to stop. So I need some RCS fuel tanks. So here's one. I'll put one on there. And that one there. I need a... Ah, here it is. Thrusters. So when I'm in space, I don't spin around like a loony. And put another set here. Okay, that's sorted. Right. Since I've put in two small ones, I might as well put a big one. We need a normal engine. Right. This is going to be a sort of a low... Oh, shit. Right. This is going to be sort of a lower stage of a rocket. So, now we need another decoupler. Decoupler. I just went past you, didn't I? Yeah, here it is. Right, decoupler. Now we're gonna bring in the big shit. Big rocket. Need to raise it a little bit high for this. Okay. Giant fuel tank. Huge fuel tank, actually. We'll put one of these babies in. There we go, got plenty of fuel. There we go. Big ass rocket in the bottom, yeah. Alright, let's just zoom out and have a look at this thing. it's kind of awesome. Right, we need decouplers. We'll put them on the sides for the boosters. So, let's give him one of these. We'll put four on. So that. Yeah, sounds simple. Righty then, zoom in. Now I'm gonna make the boosters. You can just get normal boosters like these ones, but yeah, I don't feel like using them. I feel like using proper fuel tanks for this, so we need to somehow fit some of the... Oh. Fit one of these buggers on. There we go. And also, we will also put one of these on there as well. No, not them. No. One of these, yes. That's better. We'll also need some cones for the top, so it doesn't slow me down while in the air. Right. This is something a bit more technical, this bit, next bit. This next bit is the fuel lines, of course, the fuel lines. I have to press the pause button, which is the button to zoom out. I'll just have to do it like this instead. Keep forgetting that. Stupid bandicam. Yes. We need the fuel lines, which are these. What we'll do is we will do that and that. Basically what you do is, as I'm going up in the air, it transfers fuel from these tanks into the big tanks. So once these separate off, the big tank will still be full. It's a really efficient way of saving fuel and you're not wasting any. One last thing, some structural shit for it, so it isn't wobbled out like shit. So put some of these on. And also a couple here. So there's gonna be one. There's gonna be one here. Okay, there we go, so it doesn't wobble. I think that's no, I'm wrong. I am missing something. I'm missing the good old flaps, because when it's in the mid-atmosphere it will wobble like shit, so it needs something to keep it support. So we'll put some winglets on here. Always you see as part of the jets, which I'll show you in another episode, but we're sticking to basics in a moment. Now I'll put some fins all over this fucker. Oh, whoa, that's weird. Alrighty then. Right, I think we've got that bit sorted. Right, if we can see on this side here, we can see all the staging. So what we'll do is we'll move the main engine to go at the same time with the boosters, so they all go at once. And the boosters will most likely run out of fuel first, so we'll send the boosters off after that. Then that will detach, and then it'll have the booster here to send it the rest of the way. Yeah, I think this will be good. Alright, just one last check. Make sure this works, and what I'll do is I'll put some of these on it. Some structural stands. There we go. Right, the last good thing is to rename it. What should we call it? We should call it... we'll call it the Sega V2. I don't know, I'm taking the name of a company, but fuck it. Okay, I think we're pretty much ready, guys. Yeah, let's save. Nope. I keep fucking up staging. Put that under there. Okay, sorted. Alright, save. Off we go, we're gonna launch. Hopefully it doesn't crash. Please don't crash. Come on. Come on. Oh. Oh, is it working? Yeah, it's worked. Okay. Yes, computer's starting to live up to its days, but, yes. Okay, dokies. Let it load, let it load, let it load, let it load. Okay, it's ready. This is the rocket in all its glory. Fucking hell. Freaking hell. Okay, make sure everything's working. Is the throttles up good? Yeah, that's up. Got the SAS module, so that's good. RCS, yeah, that works, definitely. Don't want to waste any of that. Let's have a look at map of the world. Let's see. Oh, it's quite nice. We need to get up to 100,000 feet to get a good orbit, so what I need to do is, as well, is when I get to 10,000 meters, as you'll see up here, I'll need to start tilting to the right, so yeah, we need to do that. Right, I think we're almost ready. Okay, SES is on, fuel is on max. Right, in 3, 2, 1, go. Off we go to orbit, and it's wobbling already, shit. This ain't gonna be good when we get into the high atmosphere, but hopefully it should hold. Oh shit, we're getting overheat from the boosters. It should hold out, otherwise we're gonna... not gonna make it. We'll put the main jumbo engine on max. Which is also overheating as well, which is not good. Let's bring it down a little bit. Right, boosters coming off. Sweet. Now going the rest of the way. I mean, slowing down slightly, but never mind. We need to get to the rest of the way. It seems to be holding. Well, it is wobbling like shit, but it should It's holding its spot. It's holding its place. Oh, Jesus. One thing I need to do is, as I'm getting higher, I need to lower the throttle so I'm not wasting fuel. Because I need to get as high as possible at a good angle. And also the overheating stopped, which is good. Yes, that's good. Okay, dokies. We need to bring the throttle down a little bit more. We're coming up to 7,500 feet so far, so... No, 1,000 meters. I'm getting really screwing up on that, but never mind. We're getting there very slowly. Alright, it's coming up to 10,000. We need to start turning about now-ish. So, SES off. And slowly turning to 45 degrees. This ball you see in the bottom is basically the main important tool for this game, because you don't look at the screen, you actually look at the ball. Because the ball is the thing which basically helps you the entire way. Because without the ball, you're pretty much fucked unless you're one really skilled pilot. Unfortunately, I'm not that, but it really does help. Right, so we've got to keep going like this. I can bring down the throttle a little bit more now because I'm at an angle. This also helps with trajectory as well, and also saving fuel. And also we get faster quicker, so it helps everything. As you can see here, we see a line forming. This is the apoapsis, the highest point of you're possibly going. It's slowly climbing, of course, and also the T with the seconds gradually climbing is how long it'll take me to get there. As you can see, it's slowly, gradually getting higher and higher and higher. And yeah, we need to get that to 100,000. It'll gradually get quicker and quicker, of course. Normally I'd floor it, but I need to save my fuel, and so I'm going to keep it at a gradual speed and keep climbing very slowly. So yeah, it's quite stable actually, so that's good. I was afraid that when I decouple the big booster, the entire thing is just going to fucking fail. I hope it doesn't do that. Oh god, that'd be a failure! But yeah, so far it's doing quite well. Actually, I might need to speed up, actually. So, because the angle's okay-ish. It's kind of okay. But, I think I may need to speed up a little bit. Let's speed it up. Right, I'm going at full blast. And I'm overheating already. Oh, shit. Uh-oh. Let's go back down again. Holy shit, that's quick. Oh, altitude's climbing really quickly. Once it gets to 100,000, I need to stop it. Or I'll keep going till the fuel runs out, actually. Makes it more better. Right, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Right, fuel's run out. Decouple. Right, that's sorted. Now, this is the bit which helps you get to orbit. Oh, fucking hell, I got a high orbit. This is the bit that helps. On the apoapsis, you basically click and you can add a maneuver. This little key thing here helps you determine maneuver, and you basically can adjust. As you can see, this orange yellow line forming. If you move in a certain position and put on your thruster for a certain time, this is what your orbit will be if you do it right. So I'm just looking at it right now. I need to get even-ish. So that's 85,000, so this is about right-ish, to be honest. So it's a little bit of an angle, but we can always basically need to click on the one which looks like a tail fin. Yeah. But yeah, kind of the corner kind of fucked up there, but yeah. Don't mess with all these other ones just yet, because they will fuck it up completely. But if we go back onto the ship, we'll see a bluey sort of cross thing on the nav ball, and we need to point the ship towards it. And thank god with RCS I can actually turn it, but I need to be really like careful with the fuel, because I don't want to waste it all. Okay, RCS on that point. I kind of a bit off, but okie dokie. Oh, nearly there, nearly. Okay, nearly there. I'm trying to get bang on in the middle. Come on. Don't screw up. Just hold it in that position. Okay, hold it in that position. It can't be that hard. Come on, hold it. You holding? No, it's just gonna rotate. Right, what we need to do is we need to turn on the thruster at exactly 2 minutes and 10 seconds, but I'm not going to wait that long because I'm not that stupid, so I'm going to speed up time. And I can't do it wherever I'm throttled up, so fuck that. I'm just going to take that off for a second, I'm going to speed up time a little bit. So, right, we need to go in 7 seconds, throttle up. Right, we'll always go 1 second early, so it's on, it's holding, alright, go! Right, we need to keep going for another 35 seconds when the fuel should hold long enough for me to do that. If we go on to here, we'll see the orbit gradually getting wider and wider and wider, and it'll eventually form to where the yellow circle is, which is good. Right, we should be holding out, right? And thing is, I kind of like actually saving it, but I saved too much, so... because unfortunately I'll have to ditch all this fuel. Right, I'll have to stop in about nowish. Okay, that's that saved. Now we can ditch this. Now our satellite's free. It's in orbit. Right. Kind of funny because we've ran out of RCS fuel, but it's still. We can go up to maneuver and delete it, and now we are in orbit. Yes, we are in orbit. A success. And there's our debris just behind us. That's going to crash back down to the Earth, or Kerbin, as it's called. Yeah, we got a satellite working. Sweet. Right, we need to get the solar panels extended, so we'll extend them. That was a successful very first mission. Right, that's good. We'll also turn on all the communications. Fixed, okie dokies. And turn on this last one, so it's working. Turn that on. There we go, it's working. Right, it's all working. Right, the batteries are powering up, which is good, and I think it should work. But, yeah, we're in orbit! We're in orbit! We're in orbit! This is neat. Yep, we got into space. So let's just go around, we can see it zoom around the planet Kerbin. Oh, don't. Speeding is a little bit quickly. This is awesome. And here's the planet again. This is amazing. I think this is a rather big success. And the debris is still right behind me. Is that going to keep orbiting with me? Where is it? Ah, there it is. It's over there. Somewhere. Yeah. We did a good job. I think what I'll do for next episode is, next episode I'll probably, send a guy into space. Or I might try and make my first plane for you guys or something like that. Something interesting. But, yeah. Anyway, guys, like and comment on the video, and subscribe if you haven't already. Leave suggestions in the comments down below for games and ideas I could possibly do, because I really want some ideas. Also, give me ideas of shit to do in Kerbal Space Program as well, and also, leave me your views. Yeah, as always, guys, thank you for watching.